disgruntledduck.com.
Hey guys, welcome again. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for joining for another review. So this one, I'm really excited about. This is one of these models that straight away takes me back to my childhood. Must have been late 80s, early 90s. I was in the Beatty's model shop in Croydon. And I remember this coming out. I remember seeing it in the Tamiya catalogue. And it blew my mind. There was no way I was going to be getting it at that age, with the price of it being the price of it. There was no way I was going to get this model. But it's something that now, about what, 20 plus years later, it's something I've now got and I'm now going to be able to review for you. So it's the River Patrol Boats Pibber from the Vietnam War, and Tamiya 135th scale. One of the other things about this was cool, especially when it came out, is you maybe had a few boat models, but you definitely didn't have really anything in a 135th scale. So this large scale, absolutely amazing. I'd seen versions of it made up in a window of a model shop, and just blew my mind. And now I'm the proud owner of one of them. So as with a few other things, I've picked up the Edward photo etch. We pretty much know what we're going to get in there. We're just getting some up details. We've got some control panels. So that's just going to add a little bit of flavour to this model. So let's get down to what we've got in the box. Right, first off, we've got our instructions. We know with any one of our Tamiya kits, it's going to be a nice, simple build. We're looking forward to that. It gives us our paint along the way. We've got a few figures here to go in it if we want to go that way, if we're that well inclined. But the main thing is, it's a boat, and we don't really get that much chance to build boats, especially in 135th scale. So let's move this out of the way. Alright, so let's get something to cut this open with. Okay, there's the top, our deck. Again, a little bit of detail. It's going to be quite an old model, at least, I don't know, maybe late 80s, early 80s, late 80s, not too sure. Right, so there's the top, our deck, and this is our hull, one piece molded plastic. These boats were plastic or polycarbonates, so that guy looked good. That's a nice big piece of kit to paint up. That's gonna look freaking awesome. I'm really happy about that. So that guy's gonna sit like that, so you can already see what we're sort of dealing with. That's beautiful. Right, what else have we got in here? So I'm guessing this is what forms our bridge, or the front thereof. Again, quite a smooth piece, nice little bit of detailing around the side. Again, this wasn't, because it was mostly plastic, this boat, it's not going to be rivet heavy at all. So it's going to be a slightly different process when we go through that. We've got some markings. I'm kind of getting so carried away with this one, I'm forgetting some of the parts. We've got our markings, it looks for two different separate boats there. So put that to the side. Got some figures coming. So there you've got four little figures here. We've got some ammunition boxes, we've got some petrol drums, some jerry cans, we've got some machine guns, we've got a radio, looks like a grenade launcher. So yeah, we've got a nice few little bits on that sprue. Even if we don't use the figures, we can use some of these bits just to give a little bit of character to the boat. That's a nice little set of figures, and for you figure guys out there, that's a great little set to start off a diorama with. So there we go, there's our figures. Right, on to the next screw. Again, there's not a hell of a lot of parts on this, but it's gonna look so awesome. So we've got the parts of the stand here and here. I believe these are the other two parts of the stand. Then we've got the front of our boat. We've got some oil cans, some old drums, sorry. We've got some more detailed parts of the, where you'd have a cabin. I'm not too sure entirely at the moment. We've got a steering wheel, our machine gun, would you call it a tower or emplacement? Again, we've got a few big machine guns here. Lots of nice big parts. This is really gonna turn out into something quite special, I think. But yeah, that's, I think price-wise, we're looking at about £25 to £30 on this. And it's not gonna have tons of parts like some of the tanks, but it's gonna be such an awesome big model. And then our final, we've got an American flag in there as well. Paper, I believe that is. I don't think it's adhesive. So yeah, a little paper flag. We're gonna be able to cut out and use. See on the back of here. So yeah, the final sprue. I'm actually quite blown away at this. I'm really feeling quite childish at the moment, like I've opened this at Christmas. So I believe possibly a radar or radio mast. We've got the sides of where that canopy are. So this is the only bit I'm worried about. These bits are gonna be really fiddly, quite easy to break. So when I put my model builder's head on, this is the sprue that I'm most nervous about, as there are lots of tiny fiddly parts. These look like some tires. This looks like a life ring. But yeah, all in all, little lights there on the front. All in all, this is a beautiful kit. I know I'm marking out a bit on it because it's something I've always wanted and I'm really quite chuffed. I actually have it now. But yeah, this is definitely something I'd recommend if you're into that that 1/35th scale. It's a nice scale to build in. A lot of detail can be achieved. And this is a slightly more unique project than just building a Tiger tank or a Sherman or something. So yeah, check this guy out. This has been my review of it. Going to be building this guy up in the new year at some point. So check back, see how it goes. And until then, happy modelling and take it easy, guys. Right, then we've also got this little one. So I don't know if they look like, if that looks like ammunition to me. I'm not too sure what that is. It's slightly softer, more of a poly sort of plastic. Yeah, definitely intrigued as to what these are. We've got some clear parts, mostly for our lights on the front. So yeah, they look quite nice little lenses. And we've got a nice little piece of thread. So it'll be interesting to see what we get to use these for.
Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, give the video a thumbs up, and leave a comment.